They did. Now we are back.
We are back. And I have the curliest hair of all. And it will all go down in a matter of moments, really. It doesn't stay like this.
Are there any tips that you would give to anybody who is curling their hair?
Well, apparently you're supposed to like use stuff that's like a heat protector spray or something like that, which I only use sometimes, but I don't know, my hair's
kind of... Can I say something though?
What?
Because like I'm Captain Sweep and I have a very secret plan, and it's kind of like to take over the world a bit for all of us from the insane bankers. And I'm just wondering how curling your hair is part of that.
Well, I guess it's the part where you, and individually, I guess everybody can look into the mirror and think about stuff before they start their day. Have a coffee and ponder about what it is that makes you rather do mindless things like such than actually making something happen in the world, something different. I guess, vanity, I guess?
Isn't it
not about, really all that important?
Well, isn't it about balance? Like, I mean, you got to take care of your hair, I know. And
no, you don't.
You got to spend time.
Well, I got to take care of your hair sometimes.
No, but women like to spend time on hair, right? You can't take that out of the equation. That's part of this very secret plan. That's what
yes.
We're saying we can still do this while like hanging out in Zoom, having a little conversation, but it's these little conversations together that sort of unite into this larger plan where we basically take over
the world.
Yeah.
And this has to do, I don't know what this has to do about curling my hair.
Well, they never think to sort of like, they look at us and go, look, they're just talking about curling your hair. And they wouldn't even imagine that we're actually got this secret plan embedded.
To take over the world. Yeah. It's because they're like lab rats. We're like lab mice, lab rats, like Pinky and the Brain.
We're always being watched. And the thing is, if you had a plan to take over the world, you wouldn't like call it the very secret plan and put it on web TV and actually talk about it during your thing, because that would be ridiculous. That would be silly, right? Because if you had a real plan, you'd actually keep it hidden. But that's the humor of the very secret plan and the diabolical nature of the deviousness.
How can you even convince anything to anyone if you don't use humor?
You could say it all seriously, like, seriously? We're going to take over the world and this is going to happen. You know, you could say it like that, but no one's going to listen to that. They're going to be like, oh, what? You think you're so serious?
They don't even know what they're talking about.
Exactly.
I get you.
So if you use humor, people actually learn because they think it's so funny.
Yeah, right? I am being serious.
It creates an experience that they actually can remember and actually learn. Because that's exactly how, why don't we do that in schools? This is what makes sense to me.
I've got a question. I've got a very pertinent question. What do you think of the green screen?
It's pretty cool. I was thinking,
like your background, the bathroom background you got right now, it's a little weak.
Well, yeah, like
well,
I have-
you do your hair. So
this is weak. My bathroom is weak. Look at my mosaic.
There. That's what we need as a background.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. There we go.
I don't have anywhere to hold the phone to do that.
You need a camera person. Or just a stick, right? One of those logs.
Yeah, a selfie stick. Maybe.
Okay, we've been talking too long, I think.